Hello students, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will discuss about the Wagner's theory. Okay, this Wagner's theory or Wagner's mechanism, it is observed in the solid state reactions. Okay, it is seen in the solid state reaction. Usually, the reaction between solids is studied by Wagner. Okay, Wagner is the name of the scientist. He studied the reaction between the solids. So he called this theory as Wagner's theory or Wagner's mechanism. Okay, now just imagine you have two solids. Say A is one solid, okay, and B is the one solid. Okay, now if I want to make this A and B to react with each other, then what I have to do? If I keep the A and B at certain distance, then whether A and B react? No. Okay, if I keep A and B at some distance, okay, you can see that there is some gap between A and B, correct? If I keep the two solids at some distance, then the reaction do not take place. Okay, the solid state reaction occurs only when the two solids are kept close to each other. Okay, then the reaction is possible, but not at room temperature. Okay, if you take two solids, okay, if you have two stones, for example, if you bring it together, whether the reaction happen? No. At room temperature, there will be no reaction. But at higher temperature, that is the temperature of this range, 1000 degrees Celsius to 2500 degrees Celsius. Okay, at this particular temperature, you can see the solid state reaction. Okay, the solid state reaction is observed at very, very higher temperature. Okay, that is 1000 degrees Celsius to 1000 or maybe greater than this. Okay, so the solid state reaction do not take place at room temperature. Even though you keep two solid in contact with each other at room temperature, the reaction won't take place. The reaction occurs only at very higher temperature. Okay, that point you need to remember. Now, just imagine I have the two solid, say this is the one solid, I call it as A solid, okay, and I keep another solid B in contact with the A. Okay, this is one solid, this is the another solid, and what I did, I just combined it, or I just placed these two solid in touching with each other. Okay, so now this interface is there, no, that is where they connect is called as interface, solid interface. Okay, so interface means what? It is the point of contact between the solids A and B. Okay, now in solid state reaction, what I said, you have to heat it, right? You need to heat it at a higher temperature. Okay, at higher temperature. Okay, first you need to keep the two solids in contact with each other. Then what you need to do? You heat it at very high temperature. So what happened is that in the solid, we know that there is a cation and there is an anion. For example, if you consider NaCl solid, there is a cation, Na plus Cl minus is an anion. Similarly, here A and B are also a solid, correct? So in A also you have cation, right? And you have the anion. Similarly, in the B also you have cation and you will be having anion also. Okay, now what happens is that whenever you heat at very high temperature, the cation and anion from A as well as cation and anion from B will be migrating towards the interface. Okay, the cation and anion will be migrating towards the interface. Okay, similarly here also the cation will be migrating like this, the anion also migrating towards the interface. So that what happens is that at a certain time, or if you observe after a certain time, what happens is that initially this was the interface, correct? Initially this was the interface between A and B solid. But now what happened? The cation and anions are migrated towards the interface, so that the thickness of this interface increases. Okay, the thickness increases. Okay, you can see a very thick interface now. Okay, it is after some time. Okay, it is initially, but if you heat it for a certain time, then if you observe, then what happened? The interface thickness grows. Okay, now this is called as the product layer. okay, the product layer. Why? Because at this interface the product take place, okay, formation of the product take place at this interface. Okay, initially it was single line, right? But after certain time, what happened? Because of migration of cation and anion from either side of the solid, the thickness of the interface increases, and that is called as product layer. Okay, so let me give an example of magnesium oxide and alumina, that is Al2O3. Okay, now just imagine MgO as a solid and Al2O3 as a B solid. Okay, here I took A and B. I just gave an example for what might be A, what might be B. Okay, here A solid, what's the cation? Cation is Mg2 plus, and anion we know it is O2 minus. Okay, in case of B, alumina, Al3 plus, and anion is what? Once again, it is an oxide ion. Okay, in both the solid we have the same anion, but anyhow cations are different. Okay, now for any reaction to occur, okay, for any reaction to occur, what should be the condition? The delta G should be negative, correct? This is the thing we already know, that is, for any reaction to happen, the delta G should be negative. Okay, we know that from the thermodynamics, the equation for this delta G is given by what? Delta H minus T delta S. Okay, this is from the thermodynamic constant. Okay, this is the equation you have for the Gibbs free energy, change in Gibbs free energy. Now, since we are talking about solid state reaction, what is the delta TS? Delta TS is negative, correct? For solid state reaction, delta or any solid, delta TS is negative, correct? Why? Because in the solids, if you consider this is the solid, the atoms are very, very close to one another, right? So there will be no space for the migration of the atoms, so its entropy will be very least. While for the liquid it is little greater than that of solid, while for the gas, yes, delta S is positive, it will be more. Okay, delta S is negative in case of solids, or in the case of solid state reaction also it is negative only. Okay, so now if you put that delta S negative in this equation, what you get? Delta G is equal to delta H. Okay, T is what? T is the temperature, correct? For the solid state reaction, what is the T? I just now said it is very high, correct? T is very high, temperature is very high, delta TS is negative. Now, minus, this is the minus, and delta TS is also a minus. Okay, let me write minus T, delta S is what? It is negative, correct? Delta TS is equal to delta G, you get minus into minus plus, correct? T delta S. Okay, now, it is delta H, yeah? Here delta G. Okay, now we know that for any reaction to happen, what should be delta G? It should be negative, correct? Now, in order to make this delta G negative, it depends on delta H. Okay, since delta S is negative, so we cannot do anything, right? So if I want to make this delta G negative, it depends on what? Delta H. What is delta H? Enthalpy, change in enthalpy. Okay, now just see this equation. If delta H is positive, what happened to delta G? If delta H is positive, delta G is also a positive. That means the reaction won't happen, right? If the delta H is negative, okay, if delta H is negative, then only delta G is a negative, right? According to this equation, if delta H is a negative, delta G also negative, then only the reaction is possible. Now, it is observed that for the solid state reaction, delta H is negative. Okay, for the solid state reaction, what is observed? The enthalpy is negative. That means what? It is a exothermic reaction. Okay? Delta H is negative means what? It is an exothermic reaction. Okay, let me change the place. Delta H is negative means what? It is an exothermic reaction. Which is exothermic? Solid state reaction is an exothermic reaction. Okay, so during exothermic reaction, what happens? Heat get liberated, correct? Heat get liberated or released during the reaction, okay? During the reaction, heat get liberated, okay? Now, because of this heat that is liberated, the rate of the reaction increases, okay? The rate of the reaction increases. Why? Because heat get liberated during the reaction, it will helps in the increase in the rate of the reaction. Okay, that means what do you mean by that? I gave an example of what MgO and what alumina, right? Al2O3. So now if you have the two solid in contact with each other, okay, this is MgO, just it is an Al2O3. Okay, what I said, whenever you heat this particular solid in contact with each other, the cation, that is Mg2+, as well as O2-, that is anion here, and here it is Al3+, and O2- is anion. These Mg2+ and oxide ions, similarly Al3+ and O2- will migrate towards the interface. Okay, this is the interface. Okay, so after a certain time, what happens? What happens is that the interface thickness grows. Okay, the thickness of the interface grows. Okay, this was the initial interface, but after a certain time, because of migration of the cation and anion, what happened? The product layer is formed. The product layer is formed. Okay, now what I said, during the reaction heat get liberated means rate of the reaction increases. That means more of the cation, that is Mg2+, and more of the oxide ion from this side, as well as more number of cation and O2- will be diffused into the interface. Okay, that is what I mean by increase in the rate of reaction. Okay, the more number of cations from either side will diffuse into the product layer. As a result, what happens? The thickness of the product layer increases. Okay, now if you see over here the charge over of the cation and anion, the anions are same, right? O2- are the anions, and cation is the Mg2+, Al3+. Okay, Mg2+ and Al3+ is the cation in the MgO and Al2O3. Okay, now there is a charge imbalance. That means it is in the 2+ state, it is in the 3+ state. Means there is a charge imbalance. Now to maintain the charge balance, okay, to maintain the charge balance for every 3 Mg2+ ion which diffuse to right hand interface, 2 Al3+ ions must diffuse to left hand interface. Okay, to maintain charge balance, what happens? For every 3 Mg2+ that is diffusing to the interface, there must be how much Al3+? 2 Al3+ must diffuse to the left hand side interface. Okay, why it happens? To maintain the charge. Okay, to maintain the charge balance, this thing happens. Okay, now let's see what are the reactions that occurs at the interface. Okay, the reactions occurring at the interface. Now we will talk about the first interface, that is interface of MgO and MgAl2O4. That means MgO is this, okay, interface MgAl2O4, okay. So in this interface, the reaction happening is 2Al3+, 3Mg2+, plus 4MgO. Give 1 Mg Al2O4. Okay, what is MgAl2O4? It is the product of the MgO and Al2O4. Okay, if you take the two solid and if you heat, the product is what? MgAl2O4. Okay, Al2, how many oxygen are there? Here 1, here 3. So it is MgAl2O4. Okay, so that is formed at the interface. That is why it is called as product layer. Now, the in this interface, which interface? In this interface, the reaction happening is 2Al3+, 3Mg2+, plus 4MgO, because here you have 4MgO, right? That is why you are writing MgO, 4 in number, to maintain a, equation, 1MgAl2O4, okay? And in the next interface, that is this interface, the reaction is the interface of MgAl2O4 and Al2O3, okay? This interface, the reaction happening is 3Mg2+, 2Al3+, plus 4Al2O3, 3MgAl2O4. Okay, this is the reaction happening at this particular interface. Okay, now let's write the overall reaction. The overall reaction is given by 4MgO plus 4Al2O3 gives 4MgAl2O4. Okay, this is the overall reaction that is happening in the entire solid state reaction between MgO and Al2O3. Okay, so the product is MgAl2O4. Now, if you see these reactions that is happening at the interface, the A and B, these are the two reactions. I just named it as 1 and this equation as 2. Now, if you see this, the reaction 2, okay, the reaction that is happening at this particular interface is 3 times that at the this interface, correct? The reaction 2 happens at the 3 times, okay, the rate of this reaction is 3 times that of this, correct? What is the meaning of that? Meaning is that this side interface, okay, that means the right hand side interface grows 3 times thicker when you compare to the left hand side interface. Okay, that is the meaning of this particular equations. Okay, by the equation it is very clear that this particular interface grows 3 times the this interface. Okay, so here the thickness of this interface will be 3 times that of this. Okay, so this is this particular reaction is studied by Wagner. Okay, it is studied by whom? It is studied by the Wagner. That is why this theory or this solid state reaction is called as Wagner's theory, or it is also called as Wagner's mechanism. Okay, it can also be called like solid state reaction also. Okay, because the reaction is happening between the two solids. Okay. This is about Wagner's theory or Wagner's mechanism. If you have any doubt in this video, please let me know in the comment section. Okay, if you like this video, please like the video and please share it with your friends and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.